Thank you for the opportunity. Good evening, everyone. I'm Afifa Jayanti as the first author, and Dimas Indiarto Satrio Irfan and Dr. Esmeralda Contessa Jamal from the Department of Informatics, Universitas Jenderal Ahmad Yani. This time, we will present our paper, Hybrid NNRNN in Motor Imagery Identification of Brain-Computer Interface. The outline that I will discussing our introduction, literature review, method, result and discussion, and conclusion and future works. First is the introduction. Command to move limb can be identified by analyzing movement signal in the human brain. With the brain-computer interface or BCI, it's possible to drive external device based on thought without involving gesture, muscle, voice, and other motor function. BCI is determined mainly from the intermediate device use. Using an electroencephalogram or EEG, the use of an EEG signal recording device that involves multiple channel will result in data redundancy. Therefore, a multi-channel identification and handling method is need that pays attention to the sequence. And the use of filtration to obtain the frequency range of the wave under review. So this research proposed hybrid CNN and RNN method to identify BCI based on EEG signal and multi-channel handling without losing the sequence and wavelet to get a frequency range that identify four classes: forward, right, left, and stop. The next is literature review. Identification on BCI EEG has been done with various extraction and identification methods. In vitro extraction, wavelets were used to obtain component mu and beta wave as a representation of motor imagery. Wavelet has advantages in the analysis of non-stationary signal such as EEG. In identification method, the multi-channel reduction can improve the accuracy of motor imagery identification. And combination of CNN-RNN in the identification of EMG signal improve the performance of the model compared to only CNN. The method of identification motor imagery for BCI is shown on the screen. First, reprocessing the EEG signal by filter wavelet filter to obtain the frequency mu and beta waves. Then hybrid CNN-RNN identified one of four classes: forward, right, left, and stop. This research used data from the previous research, which was recorded using the EEG emotive epoplus with a sampling frequency of 128 Hz with 20 participants, 5 repetitions, 60 seconds on each recording. Each data was segmented for 2 seconds, then generates 5 segments for each recording. So there are a total of 200 data set where 1600 used for the learning and 400 for testing. Then the dataset is filtered using wavelet to obtain the frequency component mu and beta wave in the range of 8 to 30 Hz using the composition. The process of filtering the EEG signal in one segment for 2 seconds will be produced 1288 data points for each segment. After processing, then this method is used for multi-channel handling and identification. CNN method is used to extract spatial feature from the channel sequence to handle multi-channel. The result of CNN will be input to RNN for training. This research uses LSTM as a variation of RNN to get temporal information in the form of sequence from any data that previously processed using CNN. The next is result and discussion. The first experiment is to compare the use of hybrid CNN and RNN as an identification method and multi-channel handling with the RNN method, which only perform identification. The hybrid CNN-RNN has accuracy of 98.62% with Adamex optimization model and use 100 EPO. They could maintain their stability as the EPO increase, while for the RNN-only method, the increase inaccuracy tends to be fast in the early epoch, but only until 85.44% of accuracy. So the use of identification method with attention to multi-channel and improve accuracy by 13.18%. The second experiment is to test the use of wavelet. The model with wavelet get higher accuracy than without wavelet, but the difference is not significant. This result shows that channel handling in identification using CNN-RNN is more dominant in improving performance, so that the use of extraction only slightly increase accuracy. However, wavelet are still recommended because of the focus on extract. They require frequency range to help improve performer. The next step is to measure the model's performance with confusion matrix. That's shown on the table for each class. Based on evaluation matrix table, the lowest precision value is in the left class. Considering that the class has more varied training data, then model can call non-training data well. However, the precision generated from each class is good, which means the model build has a good level of prediction accuracy. F1 score itself gets high result, which indicate that the value of precision and recall is also high. Also, the average score produce a similar accuracy of the computational model. Furthermore, the optimal model in this research compared with previous research on BCI. Research number 1 and 2 resulting accuracy 79.81% and 90%. Both research have not used the multi-channel handling method, while research number 3 with the same data use ICA as a dimension reduction method for multi-channel handling and RNN as identification, obtaining an accuracy 99.06%, while our research resulting in almost the same accuracy, 98.62%. This small difference is sometimes affected by the architecture or random number generation. In addition, on proposed method in much faster without sacrificing accuracy because CNN generate less data to be processed. The next is conclusion and future works. From this research, it can be concluded that the use of hybrid CNN-RNN method increased the accuracy 13.18% with a shorter learning time because CNN handle multi-channel and RNN to keep the sequence. Also, the use of wavelet can increase the accuracy compared to without wavelet because it focus on the information it need only. And the use of optimization is less influential, but Adam and Adamesh use the same dynamic technique. That because the model is robust, so that the filter and learning parameter have less effect. Hybrid CNN and RNN, so good result is identified DCI motor imagery. So it will be interesting if applied to multivariable data using the 2D CNN method as the channel extraction method. That's all the presentation I can give, and thank you.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Afifa, for your nice presentations. We have one questions in the chat. I will read it for you. Why use two methods for PCI identifications of an EEG signals? And then, and what are the benefits of PCI? This is for from Rofiko Hadian.
Okay, thank you for the question. Why this research use two methods? Because the use of multi-channel EEG signal will result in redundant data, which will also affect the computation time. So this research aim to identify and handle multi-channel that pay attention to their sequence. CNN can handle multi-channel by extracting spatial feature from multi-channel, while RNN has a good performance for processing sequential data, such as EEG signal. So this research used two method to deal with this problem. And the benefit of BCI. BCI can be used to help people with physical disabilities to move external device by imagining the movement only without involving gesture, sound, or other matter function.
Okay, thank you. I hope it is answer your questions, Rofika Hadian. Okay, I have also a question for you, Mrs. Afifa. Mrs. Afifa, I'm sorry. It's in regard with the EEG. Am I understand correctly about the, from your presentations? Are you were you doing motor imagery, right?
Yes.
Where the subjects imagines the movement of forward, right, left, and stop. Is that correct? Or do you have any kind of like a, did you use any cue for the subjects to imagine that things?
So the question is the subject.
Mm-hmm. Could you please show me the presentation, the experimental design of yours, if you do not mind, of course.
The recording, the subject was watch a screen. That screen present a movement right, left, forward, and stop. That the subject imagine to move that the object on the screen.
Oh, okay. So it means you synchronize the presentations from the display on the screens by with the time of your recording. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. So I see. So it is how can I say? Okay. That makes sense. Okay, thank you very much. And then the next questions in regard with the signals about the channel location. Okay, you said that you use a 14 channels from emotive, right?
Yes, sir.
Did you put kind of like a precisely the same among? I mean, can you get? Could you get kind of like a very conclusive idea from which channel that the strongest features for the movement appears?
For the motor imagery, that's strong at the channel central, which is
C central.
Yes.
Okay.
FC5 and FC5 and FC4.
Oh, okay. I see. That's nice result basically when you put it in your paper as well. And then also about the, did you elucidate the timing when the process of, as I know, there is a process around kind of like a 50 millisecond from the brain to move the muscles in the sensory movement basically. So is that any kind of like a delay or maybe the estimate when, did you elucidate when exactly the signals kind of like how can I say the translate between the trigger from the brain and then it will cause the real movement. Yeah, in your case is the imagery movement, of course. Is that any clues how can you get that information or not from this experiment?
This experiment can be used real time, so period every 2 seconds EEG record the signal and to process identify for classes or forward to left, right or stop.
Okay. So in this experiment you still cannot elucidate when exactly the same when we move something, kind of like for example my mouse here, I move my mouse so I can suddenly feel that the movement is at the same time. But in the case of imagery, there is a feeling of a delay, right? Whether if you try to move a kind of like a game or cursor using your brain, then there is a delay, there is a time when you trigger your brain for a movement and then the real movement happens in a monitor. Is that also happens in your study, or you just try to classify whether one certain signals can be used to discriminate the movement?
In my study, the delay is need less than a second. So as you can see on the table, 0.72 or 0.90.
So around 1 second, right? Without 700 until 900 milliseconds. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, thank you for your presentations, Miss Afifa.